up. Here, I'm going to turn it all the way up and see if I can blow it up. Hold on.
Yeah, I think that was Jehuzi.
Oh, that's all the way up.
There it is. That's all the way up. Let's see. Oh, yeah, that's working. That's pretty much working.
You better get a bigger amp.
Well, it's pretty big, but it's not huge. Yeah, we don't want to hear anything from the libtard out of Ripley. The libtard Ripley. That's hard to say, over. Yeah, I'm legal. I'm over 18, over.
Italiana was a woman.
Over legal limit.
Well, I was trying to reach N1 UZI. He's a good friend of mine. I call him Machine Gunner Tommy. I wonder why he left, over.
Over. Oh, this is...
Why did he leave? Why did he leave, over?
You're a
kilo, man. Well, I don't know. Am I splattering? I'm, shouldn't be.
Somebody claims difficulty.
No, the reason I wanted to talk to N1 UZI there, Dan, was
time to time.
Oh, he's still talking.
Pointers, let him know what he's doing wrong, but Joe's a little slow on the uptake.
Yeah, well, the reason I wanted to talk to him there, whatever your name is, you're so insignificant, I keep forgetting your name. Yeah, the Ripley retard, that's how I remember you.
You can talk all you want.
Okay, yeah, Ripley retard. The libtard out of Ripley. The man that votes straight Democratic. I just wanted the Southern boys to know that.
Just like
this. Yeah.
Didn't cost a thing. It's not that difficult.
Okay, that's what I'm doing. I was trying to get a hold of N1 UZI. Because there were rumors that the reason he was off the air was because the state was giving him free room and board there. That's what the rumor was on the SDR chat line, was that somebody was giving him free room and board, if you know what I mean, over. I've given up on being nice. I tried that for a day and it didn't work.
Wow, Joe tried to be nice for a day, boys and girls. Everybody give him a round of applause.
Yeah, it didn't work. It failed miserably.
Why not for a gold star?
Well, my letter said that, I can't go into the details. I'm going to sue the FCC just for the fun of it.
Yeah, well, good luck
anyway,
with that, Joe.
Back to N1 UZI. He said he had to take his microphone off of his radio. Oh, my God, that shows such a lack of discipline, It's like a guy putting a combination lock on his liquor cabinet because when he's drunk, he can't remember the combination. I mean, that's pretty terrible there, Ripley retard. How's it going there, Tard? Over.
I had a
chance. Just like you, Joe. I mean, I swear to God, you got blue hair, but you and her voice were so much alike. It's just absolutely incredible.
Well, it brings back memories for you, I'm sure, but it's
pretty,
memories are kind of a hard thing for you, Dan, with all that alcohol
or is that
one
of your
memories? You don't remember much of anything, over.
That one right there is so adorable. I mean, we're talking pink socks, lavender shoes, white belt. You know what I'm talking about, don't you, Jim?
Yeah, I remember when Gravel Balls named Dan the Ripley. Oh, that was funny. I'm talking about, that's way back in the day. That was, Dan was known as the Ripley retard.
I believe the voice you used on 14313 was your Southern Belle voice there, Joe.
Oh, that was funny.
You know, the whole time you were on 14313, you never gave your call.
Well, I don't have any recollection of that, of course.
But those voices you have, they are so sweet. I mean, did you work on them for a long time, Joe?
Where did Tommy go? N1 UZI, are you still in there, over? Oh, my God, solitary confinement. Oh, Lordy. My God, that's what they do to libtards over there in Illinois. I thought that was a libtard state there, Dan. What happened?
3-year-old recording?
What? I hear you. Is that F.O. or J.F.A.? I always get them mixed up. Over.
Sitting there talking to a 3-year-old recording. Yo, you don't want to make yourself look like a complete ass on the radio. Don't talk to recordings. It's not behooving of you.
No, N1UZI was in there, and now JFA or FO is in there. I get them mixed up. I can't tell them apart. So, and then Scotty over there in the frozen tundra of North Texas, he's in there.
Now, I want you all to observe really closely. When Joe goes in the radio mode, he's not really talking to anybody. Joe just waits till he thinks someone's not teed up, then he tees out and he rattles on endlessly about nothing. That's K1 LEM stick there, Joe. You shouldn't steal that from old No Neck, More Shins than the Chinese phone book.
Well, if you would be halfway observant, Dan, you would have noticed that on the
chat thing there, people
have said there's a real photo, there's a real video of Wit, of LEM, out there on YouTube, and it's got his photo in it. It's got him sitting there talking into his microphone. So he's not 400 pounds. Matter of fact, he looks like he's less than half that. No, his photo is on YouTube there, Dan. If you look, they talked about it on the chat line. His photo's there, and believe me, he doesn't have multiple chins, and he's not 400 pounds. Over.
K1 LEM? Oh, isn't that the sweetest little thing? I didn't think you'd take time out of your busy schedule.
Well, I'm trying real hard. I'm running all the power I can. That's doing pretty good. I'm getting that... What's that? Plate and Peeries. What's that mean, Dan? Over.
Joe just loves to sit and hear himself talk. Joe's being K1 LEM's defense lawyer there. Joe, you need to defend K1 LEM.
No, I threw him under the bus, Dan. Didn't you catch that? I threw him under the bus. Over.
And what you need to do is go over there and console him, you know.
Console him?
Mercedes, throw on the knockoff Rolex, drive over there, and give him a big hug.
Can someone tell me what plate and Peeries means? What's plate and Peeries? Over.
You drove your little Mercedes over there to 215 Applebark Lane in Inman, South Carolina, knock on the door, and you get your arms around him, you need to go up there and give K1 LEM a big hug.
Dan, what's that mean on that meter that I got there? It says plate and Peeries. What's that
Joe
mean, over?
You knock on the door and say, ho-ho! Hey, little buddy, I'm over here to console you. Let me wrap my arms around you with my Rolex.
Thanks for listening to Rolex in the first place. ACYDD.
K1 LEM, I just want to tell you my favorite.
So, Dan, the reason I wanted to talk to N1UZI...
That thing, you know how Joe does this? Whenever I do the same thing back with Joe and just sit there and rattle on endlessly without any sort of response to Joe, I actually do this to show Joe what it's like talking to him when he's one of his little let his hair down tirades and that light in the loafer's voice. Joe, do you like me in this mode? I'm doing my Joe. It's my best Joe Italian. Right now.
Oh, the reason I wanted to talk
That's
to you.
That's the reason why I'm
here
talking to you, Joe. I want to show you how to do your best AC1DD. What you do, Joe, is you just key up and you just continue talking, no matter whether you hear anything or not. It's like if you have paper in front of you. You know, kind of like the newsroom.
Well, the reason.
The reason why I'm in here letting you know what you sound like there, Joe, is because nobody cares, Joe. I mean, you really need to work on it. I mean, can't you beep it up? Can't you get a little bit lower there, Joe? Lower your voice there, Joe. And that way, it won't sound like we're talking to my aunt. And I didn't particularly like her anyway there, Joe. but you have a voice just like my aunt.
Okay, well, the reason that I wanted to talk to Tommy McLaughlin, something like that.
You know, the reason why I'm telling you is the reason why. And that's the reason why I'm telling you.
Okay, well, I'm trying to tell you.
Okay, well, I'm just, you know, the reason why I'm letting you know that there, Joe, is so that you understand the why. I know you get confused a lot, and I'm going to come up here and show you the reason why. The reason why, Roger?
Roger, on the, yeah, the reason.
You know, on the Roger, yeah. You know where them deals are, yeah. Yeah, Roger, and that's the reason why.
Yeah, I understand that.
I understand that too, but there's always a but. The reason why you have so much difficulty is because you're, I don't know, I think you're unhappy.
I think you really are unhappy.
I don't think you're with the amateur radio. I mean, if you're not happy with it, I go out and buy me a new one. You know, try something different. But the reason why, I'm telling you, is because of the reason why.
Yeah, the reason that I wanted to...
The reason why I'm letting you know that is because that's the reason. You know, if you were really, really searching for a reason why, well, I'm your reason why there, Joe.
Well, back to N1UZI.
Back to AC1DD. AC1DD is confused and he needs some help. And that's the reason why I'm out here, is to walk little Joey through all these little problems. You know, Joe has this insecurity about whether he's being heard or not. And I like that routine where you think if you just the reason why and rattle long enough that somebody might catch a little snippet of what you're saying. Well, that's the reason why.
Well, the reason that I wanted to...
No, the reason why you do it there is because you just like to sit there and rattle. And I don't mind that. You know, if you didn't have such a girly voice there, if you didn't sound like you were lighting loafers, I might be able to tolerate it. But that's the reason why I'm in here helping you out, Joe. And the reason why is because I have a reason why.
Well, I was trying to...
I'm just trying to enlighten you in your radio operation, Joe.
I'm trying to help you out there, buddy.
So that you can figure out the reason why.
Well, I was trying to talk to him, Dan, because...
I'm trying to talk to you, but you're too busy talking. And what I'll do is I'll do like you do, there, Joe. I'll just talk until you unkey, and that will be the reason why you heard me. See, the reason why you don't hear anybody, Joe, is because you're talking most of the time. The reason why is because you have the trigger pulled down. Now, if you unkey the little microphone there long enough and put that little feminine voice in park for a second, that could be the reason why you're here.
Well, it's interesting that you mentioned trigger, because that's why I wanted to talk to N1UZI.
It's so interesting that you brought that up, because the trigger is what is down on you at the moment. Now, there might be somebody out there in your local area or maybe a half a state away or something like that hearing you. But the reason why nobody else is hearing that stuff is because the reason why is because I'm talking.
Well, I hear you talking, Dan.
This is the Joe Italiano style of talking.